How's it going?
Not bad.
Can I get your name and badge number?
Sergeant Chris Thompson, officer number 6689.
What's going on here today?
An investigation.
You looking for somebody?
It's an investigation.
Mm-hmm. I haven't seen that dude in a while. What's up, Vermont? Got some cops looking for somebody. I do kind of know who they're looking for, but I don't know why they're looking for him.
Quick question for you. Do you know anything about the Pinion Terrace, Pinion Heights apartment complex that's on the avenue?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Good morning, firm audits. Hey, good morning.
Morning, how are you?
I'm doing well, how are you?
Good.
What's going on?
Not much. You?
Wondering why cops are surrounding a building over here.
Well, they're conducting an investigation. I'm here for security.
Mm-hmm. Right on. Yeah, so the guy they're looking for lives on that second floor, I think. Which would be a big jump. Be a big jump down to the flat grass. Could be done.
This is alarm 1125 South Camino Del Rio at sea level, audible bird, zone 2 sales floor, and zone 1 front door.
Can I get your name and badge number, please?
Jim Martindale. We got a call number and a P number, which is 3380.
3380. Thank you. Yeah, they're looking for somebody here. cops are not inside Kristen. They're just outside. They're trying to get in. They're trying to find somebody. And the door sounds like it's locked because they were banging on it. Or the person's not letting them in, one of the two. It is, Kristen. And I think the guy they're looking for drives that orange Honda. Haven't seen him in a while. This is Durango Police Department. Yep, they've been pretty friendly to me so far today.
Go police, anybody inside, make yourself known. Go police, if you're in the house, make yourself known.
If you don't mind stepping back over there.
Over where?
Just down on the bottom of this hill, because I need to take this corner. I can't have you behind me.
Well, I'll be behind you if I'm
over there too, right?
Okay, yes, please, just move back down over there. Thank you.
Can I get your name and badge number?
Ball 1902.
Durango Police!
So this officer doesn't want me to hear or see what's going on.
He's trying to obstruct my investigation.
His name is Ball. Search warrant.
So they got a search warrant.
Exactly, fentanyl fluid. So they just went inside through the deck sliding door. So you're watching Press for Transparency. We're here in Durango, Colorado. What's the date? Today's Thursday. What is the date today? July 25th? Today, July 25th? Thank you, Felix. Today is July 25th. We're in Durango, Colorado. We're watching Press for Transparency, where the police are conducting a search warrant. Police have a search warrant for this home, or some sort of warrant. So that's why they're here. They just entered through the sliding glass door or the deck. I don't know if anyone's inside. But we'll find out soon because we got some sort of a warrant. and some evidence bags. Got some big evidence bags. Looks like they're getting ready to collect evidence. Sounds like this guy's in trouble. Well, I don't know this guy very well. I think he's a painter in town. He's a painter, and his license plate says he's a vet. That's about all I know about him. I think he's self-employed. Not sure how much he works, but. Looks like there's a camera up on his light fixture. Looks like a camera. So it appears that they did not break in the front door to access the home. They went through the sliding glass door, which was most likely unlocked. Saw the detective go in the sliding glass door and without having to cause any damage. So at this point, there's just a bunch of detectives inside the unit.
Looks like they're gathering evidence to put into paper bags.
I have no idea what the evidence is about or what the warrant was about. Right now, there's about 4 detectives inside. All right, see you later, firm. Audits. Well, they had some cops at the front and the back just to watch security to see if anyone runs it out, I suppose. Now they just got one standing in the front while the detectives go through and collect the evidence inside. Funny fennel. Oh yes. That would be pretty funny. So right now I could hear the detectives putting stuff in a paper bag. This guy's got a bunch of paper bags.
So they can color match any. But just take whatever works. I mean, there's like, you know, there's. Just remember, it's DTM, direct amount.
Hey, thanks.
Thank you so much for the ride. And I will have a great time in Durango.
Yes.
This is the guy whose unit they're searching. That's the guy who lives in that home that they just went into.
Yeah, I don't have the only thing I've got in my room is
so they were just in that guy's house, the guy in the white shirt. They were in his home. They were in his condo with evidence bags. So I'm not sure what's going on yet. What's up, standing tall?
Yeah, very strange.
I agree, Finn. Floyd. How's the video quality today, guys? How's the video quality? Thank you for the feedback. I never know what quality is going to be with the, I'm doing this. Okay, good to know. So the resident had just returned from what appears to be some sort of biker adventure. He went in with the detectives and I have no idea what this is about, really. I other than some search warrant. They got a warrant of some sort. And they're collecting evidence. That's about all I know. To the detectives have left. I got, so there should be two more detectives inside still. There's one officer standing guard outside. If you're watching Press for Transparency, we're here in Durango, Colorado. Date is July 25th. Not sure what the time is. What I'm observing is a bunch of peace officers who have just conducted some warrant, or just acted out on a warrant. Looked like the detectives were collecting evidence earlier. Evidence they were collecting or what the warrant was about. What's up, my high community channel? How we? Yep. Hey, whatever happened to the e-bikes the police department used to use? Durango Police Department had some electric mountain bikes they used to patrol on. Haven't seen them in a while. What does that mean? Oh, you're number 21. Nice, Howard County Observer. What's up, Joe Coe, Kansas? Well, Four Corner Fist in the air. Welcome in. The resident came home just a few minutes ago. They did not arrest him, but it appears that there's some sort of warrant that the officers had. So they had evidence bags that they brought inside with them. And the resident went inside with them. And so now there's two detectives inside. Yeah, so the person who lives there, Four Corner Fist in there, he's back at home. But I still don't really know what the officers are here for. They are, they're inside with the resident now. Two of the detectives left. there's a resident there. Maybe there's two residents that live there. Yeah, that was one of the residents. I don't know if there's another resident that lives there. That guy definitely lives here. And he's driving away. So I'm not really sure. Again, don't have much info. There might be another resident that lives there whose belongings they are going through. Can hear the crackling of the paper bags, the evidence bags up there. It's up Huntington Township Watch. So we're here in Durango, Colorado. We are watching Durango Police Department act out on a warrant. It sounds like they're collecting evidence right now in paper bags. Really don't know much about the evidence. So that was kind of interesting. The resident came home, went into the unit and left while the warrant was being carried out. So I'm not sure who else lives there, or if anybody. He's got the six. He's a security. Huntington Township. So do those DJI cameras allow you to hook up external microphones? So we are here in Durango, Colorado, where peace officers are acting out on a warrant for this unit. Just earlier, I saw some detectives climb up that blue ladder onto the deck and through the sliding glass door. In the past, the homeowner of this unit killed himself and his entire family. I'm not sure who owns it, but just an interesting piece of background information about this property. Yeah, I don't know who owns it now, but the history of the last owner, or the previous owner, was pretty tragic. I was told that the homeowner killed himself and his entire family. And that was in some other country. I don't even think that was here in the U.S. Those DJI cameras sound pretty useful. You can connect remotely to a microphone, huh? Like through Bluetooth, I suppose? To a lapel microphone or handheld microphone of some sort. They got their evidence. Okay. Okay, so this is the roommate right here. Now I know who that is. This is the guy
who lives upstairs with the other guy.
This is his car.
If you're on text, you want to do 360 real quick?
Yeah.
So this is the perp's car.
Okay. Alright, sounds good. Yeah.
This is the perp's car, guys. So this is the other resident's car who lives upstairs. So the guy who searched, whose home they were searching, this is his car. One of them. So right now I'm about 20 feet from them. Looks like they're searching the car. This is the car of the man who lives upstairs.
Yeah, but they didn't give any info on this stuff on the warrant. Just photograph.
We're in Durango, Colorado.
At a condominium complex. So the police just acted out on a warrant for this residence here on the second floor. Looks like the resident whose car they're searching, he's not here. I'm not sure where he is. They came out of the home with some bags of evidence in paper bags. Now they are searching this car. Documenting evidence. Whatever they find in the car, they're documenting. Hello.
Filming for training purposes only.
Oh. For posterity.
Yeah.
And transparency. See that bike rack?
It's packed with bikes.
They're just sitting there rusting. So they are documenting evidence as part of their warrant. You get the black blanket to help eliminate glares and things like that when they take their pictures. So the police had a warrant for this upstairs unit behind them. And I'm not sure what they were collecting. But it's evidence of a crime, most likely. The blanket itself is the evidence in this case. Looks like maybe both the blankets were evidence. I thought they were taking a picture of something in front of the blanket, but the blanket itself. We got a bunch of blankets that they're looking at in this car. That's a hammock. So they found a hammock and some blankets. And they found some other evidence they held out in paper bags. had no clue. So it looks like this guy's got some camping gear in his car. So Northwoods Press. I am here in Durango, Colorado, where the cops are conducting a search warrant. Good to see you, Northwoods Press. So the man who owns this car, not sure where he is. If he's in jail, if he's at work, if he's on the run. These cops just searched his home. They pulled some evidence out of his home in paper bags, and now they are searching his car. Just seen a bunch of camping gear in the car so far, and it looks like they a lot of package. A box. Have his key fobs. I didn't see them take any of that stuff with them. So they were just taking pictures of his belongings. And these guys don't want to talk to me at all. They're trying to be really quiet about what they're saying. So I think what's going on is they're waiting for the guy to come home. Or no, I should just be quiet now. Thank you. So that's the guy whose car they just searched. Yeah, Howard County Observer, you never know what these cops are gonna do as retaliation. They could retaliate, you know, after the fact with the warrant for anyone exercising their First Amendment rights. Remember, a lot of these officers don't honor their oath. And they certainly don't appreciate me. What I'm doing. Borrowed somebody's ladder. They borrowed someone's ladder. Now they're putting the ladder back. They helped the resident get back into his home through the glass door, because it sounds like they locked one too many locks at the front door. Okay, that's funny. Well, they're being nice. They're helping the guy get back into his own house. Okay, so this is a bike rack here. I guess they designed it this way to just reduce the footprint of all the bikes being in the yard. So yeah. If you put your bike in one of these, you're kind of abusing it because it's just going to be all rusted, and over time, moisture is just going to mess it up. Look at this chain. Look at this chain ring. Look at that chain ring. It's all rusted. See, that's what happens when you leave your bike in one of these racks. If you don't have enough room in your home, put it in one of these racks outside. The rack allows you to lock it up out here. It's a space-saving bike rack. Kind of hanging up in that top hoop there. The search warrant is